गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द इंग्लिश ऑनलाइन क्लास. टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर 28 इन अवर ग्रामर बुक, दैट इज पंक्चुएशन एंड कैपिटल लेटर्स. लास्ट टाइम वी बिगिन विद द कैपिटल लेटर्स, द यूज ऑफ द कैपिटल लेटर्स, एंड वी वर डन विद द एक्सक्लेमेटरी मार्क, विद द क्वेश्चन मार्क, विद द फुल स्टॉप एंड विद द क्वेश्चन मार्क. ओके, सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द पंक्चुएशन एंड कैपिटल लेटर्स, एंड वी विल बिगिन टुडे with the apostrophe. Today we will be done with the apostrophe also. Today we will be done with the hyphen also. Today we will be done with the comma, quotation marks, okay, and colon and semicolon. Okay, so here are some apostrophe rules that where should we use the apostrophe. Okay, so apostrophe would be used when someone is possessing something. When someone is possessing something, जब किसी के पास में कुछ होता है, जब किसी की कोई belonging होती है, जब किसी की कोई property होती है, वो उसके पास है और वो उसका possessor है, वो उसको possess करता है, तब आप apostrophe use लोगे उसका position बताने के लिए, to show the position, okay? So, here is the example in front of you. Amy's ballet class, the parents' bedroom, the children's rooms. Now, अब मैं आपको यहाँ पे चीज़ दिखा देती हूँ. लेट मी शो यू एमीज बैलेट क्लास. नाउ एमी इज़ अ प्रॉपर नाउन एंड एमी इज़ अ सिंगुलर ऑल्सो. सो आफ्टर द नेम एमी हेयर इज एन अपोस्ट्रोफी एंड देन देयर इज एस. एमीज बैलेट क्लास, किसकी बैलेट क्लास, हूज बैलेट क्लास, एमीज बैलेट क्लास. द पेरेंट्स बेडरूम, नाउ यू कैन सी दैट पेरेंट्स इज द word, that is also a noun and it is in the plural. So when we are writing something in plural, so after the plural word we would place the apostrophe, but we won't place another s after that. Okay, the parents' bedroom, the children's rooms. Now I have seen many of the students writing children's. See, child is the singular, children is the plural. So we do not need to write children's. We do not need to spell children in the plural again, okay, because it is already plural. The children's room, so children, then apostrophe and then s, and children's room, bachcho ka kamra, okay. Apostrophe for contractions. Now we have already learned about it. What are the contractions? They have is equals to they have in the subject and the predicate also, and in the sentences also. I think when we were learning the question tags, I told you about the contractions, that how contractions are made. So when we are making the contractions, at that time also we would use apostrophe. Okay, so this is the third person pronoun, and then there is an auxiliary verb. So when third person pronoun they and it is combining, then we would use apostrophe. Okay, so let's move on. Now we will learn about the quotation marks. See, there are two sort of quotation marks. There are single quotation marks also, and then there are double quotation marks also. Okay, quotation marks are punctuation marks used in pairs. Okay, quotation marks वो punctuation marks होते हैं जो कि pairs के साथ में use होते हैं. To identify previously spoken or written words. किसी ने अगर पहले कोई कुछ words बोले हैं, if someone has said something significant, if someone has said something relevant, or of a famous personality, or maybe a person has told something very very important. Okay, so we would put that thing in the quotation mark. Okay, for example, Lenin said, a lie told often becomes the truth. Okay, who said? Lenin said. Lenin said, a lie told often enough becomes the truth. Now you can see that after whatever it is Lenin said, after that a colon is also there. So we will learn about the colon also, that where it is used. To signify alleged, Brutus was a friend. When we are talking about a main person, or when we are talking about any accused person, or when we are talking about even a famous personality or person who holds a very important position or title, so for that also we would use the quotation mark. Okay, to highlight the name, ships, books and plays, I wrote main camp. Okay, so now this is the example. When we are talking about books or plays or ships or novel or movies, okay, so even that time also we would be using the quotation marks. Okay, to show that a word refers to the word itself. Mistake is not a word I use. Okay. Now, for example, if someone is using a particular word and that person is not using that word often, or that person is not acting according to the word that is, you know, that is used to define that person. So even that time also we would place the quotation marks. Okay. As I told you that there are two sort of quotation marks, double and the single one. So we have already learned about it, how quotation marks are used and where are they used, and now we will learn about where the single quotation marks are placed. Okay. When you are quoting someone who is quoting someone else, जब आप उसको quote कर रहे हो जो already किसी को quote कर रहा है, then you enclose the primary speaker's comment in double quotation marks and then you enclose the thing they are quoting in single quotation marks. Primary speaker is the one who is quoting someone else. Okay, so you would start by putting that person in the double quotation marks. Okay, and then you enclose the thing they are quoting in single quotation marks. Okay, so here is the example. He said, I think she said you are awesome, but I am not sure. Okay, so here you can see that it is starting with the double quotation mark. I think she said, and now it is enclosing with the single quotation. You are awesome, but I am not sure. Okay, now let's move on to the second example. When there is a quote in a headline, Harvard archaeologist finds awesome old thing. As you can see that this is the headline. Harvard archaeologist finds awesome old thing. This is the headline. And in the middle of the sentence, you can see a quote. Yes, a single word can be a quote also. So it is enclosing in the single quotation mark. To highlight words with special meaning in certain disciplines such as philosophy, theology, and linguistics. When we want to highlight some sort of word also. Now here are the examples given that philosophy, theology, linguistics, but in any subject about any topic, if you want to highlight a special reference or highlight a special word, so even that time you would use the quotation marks, the single quotation marks. Okay, so now let's move on. Now let's talk about hyphen, that how the hyphen are used. Do use hyphens with the prefixes anti, mid, neo, post, pre and pro that precede proper nouns and numbers. Okay, so where we are using the hyphen, see, first of all, what is the hyphen? Often we call hyphen as a minus or as a subtraction mark. Okay, but they are actually known as n dash or m dash. Okay, en, n dash, em, m dash. Okay, so we use hyphens with the prefixes and with the suffixes. And where should we use the hyphen when we are using the, or when we are placing the prefixes? So anti, mid, neo, post, pre and pro that precede proper nouns and numbers. Okay, now you can see anti American, mid 1980s, post Vietnam War, pro American. Okay, so now American is a noun, 1980s is a number, Vietnam War is a noun, American is also a noun. Okay, so now you can see that prefixes and suffixes are placed here like that. Okay, in the hyphen, there is a hyphen in middle of the that. Okay, hyphens can also be used to form compound nouns. This generally helps to clear up a confusing sentence. Okay, now hyphen can also be used to form a compound nouns. Okay, when we are forming the compound nouns, at that time also we are using the hyphens. Compound noun can be hyphenated or made into one word. Hyphen, this is great setup you have got here. Okay, so you can see that between the word set and up there is a hyphen. Okay, one word, there is a great setup you have got here. Now when we are placing this word set up as a one word, then it would be written like this. But when we are placing a hyphen between that, then the set and up would be divided into two. Okay, Verb phrases shouldn't be hyphenated. Will you help me set up this TV? Okay, so verb phrases shouldn't be hyphenated. जो verb phrases होते हैं, जिन phrases में verb आ रहा है, वो verb कभी भी, वो sentences कभी भी hyphenated नहीं होते. Okay, finally hyphens are used when writing non-inclusive numbers such as a phone number. Now you can see that even this, in this sentence, this word non-inclusive, now even in that also a hyphen is placed in the middle of that. So here are the credit card number and there is a social security number. So in between that also, even aapne notice bhi kiya hoga ki jab aap kuch डायल करते हैं तो उसमें अपने आप ही हाइफन आ जाता है. व्हेन यू आर डायलिंग अ हेल्पलाइन नंबर और व्हेन यू आर डायलिंग अ कोड और व्हेन यू आर डायलिंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ ऑफिशियल नंबर और गवर्नमेंटल नंबर, देन इवन दैट टाइम आल्सो यू आर, व्हेन यू आर डायलिंग दैट, देन हाइफन इज ऑटोमेटिकली पुट इन दैट सिस्टम, दैट इज द पार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम ऑफ द फोन. ओके, नाउ हाइफनेट ऑल कंपाउंड नंबर्स व्हेन यू राइट देम आउट फ्रॉम 21 थ्रू 99. सी, now when we are writing the number in the words, even that time also we must use the hyphen. Now 78, for example, if I remove the hyphen from the middle of that, then it would be 78 like this only, but we must put the hyphen, okay, in the middle of these two numbers. 78 kittens, 29 cents an hour. Okay, now what about hyphen? Use a hyphen and space to show adjectives that modify the same adjective. Okay, now we are using hyphens where? To show adjectives that modify the same adjective, that are modifying the adjective, jo adjective ko change kar rahe hain, modify kar rahe hain. 30 to 40 for draw, but near to total failure. Okay, here are some examples of the hyphen, that how the hyphens are used. Okay, it is you know, it is a little bit more than what is given in your book, so we will further discuss it in the live classes also. So now let's move on to the use of colon. The four main uses of a colon: to introduce a list, to separate two independent clauses when the second explains the first, to introduce a quotation, to emphasize a single word. Okay, so here is the detail that where the colon is used. Okay, now here are some rules. A colon can be used before a word, phrase or clause that explains or clarifies the previous statement. Example with a word. See, this can be used before a word. Okay, now the word is love and a colon is placed before that. There is one thing a human being simply cannot do without. Okay, now what one thing human being cannot do without? So the one word is written, that is love. Okay, example with a phrase. Her goal was easily stated. It is something that is stated. Okay, now it is coming with a phrase. She wanted to win the state championships. Example with a whole independent clause. Now here the independent clause is used, and I have already explained to you what are the clauses and what are the independent clauses. Louis failed that he had, don't pronounce it Louis, it is Louis. Okay, Louis felt that he had accomplished something good. He finished all his homework. Okay, now we would move on to the semicolon. Okay, now when we are using the colon, then the two full stops or the two points are placed in the vertical manner. But when we are using the semicolon, then there would be a full stop and then there would be a comma below that. Okay, so that is how a semicolon is made. Semicolon is the type of punctuation mark that is used when someone wants to input a pause, usually between two main clauses, but doesn't want to use a conjunction. And, but, or so. The two main clauses must share a logical connection for a semicolon to be used. You cannot just combine two sentences with a semicolon that have nothing to do with each other. Now we use a semicolon to define something, to give a meaning to something, or when we are placing a meaning of something that has been already been stated. So at that time we are using the semicolon. Remember that a main clause in a main clause is an independent clause. It will have a noun and a verb and make sense on its own. Semicolons are important to know how to use. We do not use them a lot because we are more comfortable just putting a period at the end of a sentence. Okay, so I hope that you would have understood through this. Now let's move on to the examples of the semicolon. I have a big test tomorrow. I can't go out tonight. Now here is a sentence. Okay, someone is having a big test tomorrow, someone is going through some exam tomorrow, and that's why, this is the reason, that's why he or she cannot go out tonight. Okay, Star Trek was my favorite television show during the 1960s. In fact, it is my favorite television show of all time. Here you can see the independent clause, okay, put together, but they are forming a sense, and then after that a full stop is placed. Okay, you should choose ham, chicken or char grill, vegetable sandwiches, cups of tea, Bovril or coffee. If you don't mind, then lukewarm. Okay, the parenthesis is not in your course, but still we will learn about that also in our live classes. Or red wine, one of the few options that's drinkable when lukewarm. Okay, so I hope that you would have understood about it, how the semicolons are used. Another time, now how you can use semicolon for another time or for the some other reason. Another time you can use a semicolon is when you need to separate items in a list.